This episode of The Modern Rogue brought to you by Raycon.
Go to buyraycon.com/rogue and get 15% off your first purchase.
Yeah, be classy about it. Don't like be gross, being like, I'm here for Modern Rogue.
Who do you think's watching this?
Me, it's Globber de Glooblanks. That's my real name, I can't help it.
If you're a super mutant named Globby Glooblanks, Raycon might not be for you.
Also, everybody else. I mean, you know, there's one thing better than standing under a tree during a thunderstorm. It's holding a wire attached to the top of a tree during a thunderstorm.
Or electrifyingly connect your table that everyone's sitting at to an antenna that's thrown in a tree.
Somebody's gonna get radio powers. I hope it's me. I don't know what that means.
On that day, I became Radio Man. Let's get radioactive. I got a whole franchise worked out.
All right, we're back with Josh Nass of Ham Radio Crash Course.
All right, we started off learning the fundamentals of shortwave radio, how it's different from AM and FM. We learned about the licensing requirements in order to be able to transmit and how you can transmit as loud as you want once you're one of the cool kids.
Within rules, yeah.
Before we even met you, we had learned about the fundamentals of transmitting data images through SSTV, which is only one of, there's multiple protocols, I assume.
Yeah, there's different ways to send images. SSTV is just a kind of an umbrella term.
We can send something via email.
We can use the radio, similar tones, to send out email. And ships, when they're going transcontinental, just hobbyists, like out sailing, they use this system to send word to their family that they're okay.
Now, give us the basics as to how it actually works.
Right, so it's taking the data format of the email and it's turning it into an audio tone, basically.
I understand that part. Mm-hmm. That's just straight up modems. But I could go out in the middle of the ocean and shout in a radio tone. I don't understand how it ends up being an email in somebody's
cell phone. Sure, he does it all the time. Then all the dolphins come, it's weird.
So we basically take the data packet and transmit it over the air in that modem tone. The receiving station can either then take it and connect it to the internet in like a gateway kind of sense, or we can go peer-to-peer. We can go from station to station until it gets to the destination.
But by its very nature, shouldn't it be a two-way communication? Does the receiver station say message received, or it just listens?
So it's actually a series of handshakes. So I'm going to call out to the receiving station and say, I have an email, and they'll send back, I'm ready to receive your email. And it's a series of acknowledgments.
Do other ships participate in the network, like out at sea?
I have not seen that, but it's possible
that would make sense, wouldn't it? Yeah.
That seems kind of like a no-brainer, right?
Yeah, right?
There are digital modes that are specifically designed for that. We have mesh networking, for example, that we can kind of like create these nodes and extend them. One of them is just like a chat program where we can boop, 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 and it'll send it across and through other stations to get back to the original.
You're just adding links in the chain so you can kind of hot potato this message.
You're adding links, but you're also adding time, because it's not like the internet or your phone at a high frequency. These are lower frequencies, so this data is gonna be slower. It takes longer to send that data out.
Who pays for this? Is this all done out of the goodwill of the hearts of the people who run the stations?
It is, yeah. This is all manned by amateurs. That's what amateur radio really means, is non-professional. We're not paid to do this. We just do it for fun.
Okay, so let's talk about what it takes to make all of this happen. You have a transceiver, transmitter and receiver.
Right, I'm running a Yaesu FT891 radio with an audio interface.
Okay, and then we hung an aerial and a ground.
Right.
So that we're able to set up a fairly long range reception.
Right, and that's called a half wave end fed antenna.
How do you know which station that you're looking for?
So I'm using software called Winlink Express, and Winlink Express has a list of all the public receiving stations and their frequencies. And you basically kind of just go down the list based off of how far it is away from you until you find one that can receive you.
And you know that you have a connection because you transmit, hey, how's it going? And you get back, hey, hi, I'm receiving you.
So much like we did with the two-way radios, we send out that call sign. So the computer's sending out the digital version of my call sign saying, hey, are you receiving? And it sends back, yes, I am, I'm
ready.
And
of course, it's worth noting that all of this is happening unencrypted and in public. So this is not a terribly secure way to communicate.
Right, so everybody needs to remember there's no encryption. There's no secrets in ham radio. Everything's generally out in the open. And you could, if you were so inclined, decode this.
I mean, do we just want to give it a try?
Yeah. Do you want to leave the room?
Yeah, I'll leave the room. You tell me when I can come back and
He's
read whatever.
He's using this as an excuse to go to the air conditioner.
Yeah, why don't you send him the missile codes, right?
So, okay. These are the missile codes. Grilled cheese.
Wait, hold on, I don't want to hear anything. Well then don't listen! I'm gonna leave. I'm going in the other room.
Okay, go.
It's not grilled cheese anymore. We're changing that one. I don't even know if I spelled that right. Boxcar.
There you go.
Homecoming. Contra 2. Dragon. Janiman. Okay, I think that's good.
Okay, so literally by adding more characters, we're increasing the amount of time of transmit.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah, so this is fine. This isn't a big deal. But just keep that in mind, too. These are short, little bursty emails so that you just say, hey, Mom, I'm alive.
Okay, so you can't really write, like, or shouldn't
you
write
can.
Some sort of long epistle.
You can.
It'll just take a lot.
I would say that it's based off of your risk of how important the communication is. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to save this to the outbox.
Okay.
So much like you used to have to do back in the old days of not having a modem connection.
Yeah. So I'm literally like putting it in an outbox.
I'm posting it to the outbox, now it's there, and when we're ready, I will click that start button, which will begin the contact session for the remote station.
Okay.
All right.
Oh, have you sent it already?
Not yet, we
okay,
have
right.
not.
I'm not looking. You have a vital message from the field.
Right, I've posted it to the outbox.
Oh, this looks like Eudora back in the day.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
1995. Yeah.
Let me align the rabbit ears, basically. So. We have white noise just in the background. If I click the start button.
Would it help if we're being quiet? Like, do the computers prefer that?
No.
When it's going quiet, that's us transmitting.
The quiet is the transmission, yes.
Got it. That's it, trying to respond.
Oh, it said failed though, so we have to do it again.
Okay.
What we're looking for too is to make sure that nobody else is using the frequency. So that could be somebody else transmitting
their message.
I just want to make sure, normally, it'll tell you a warning that it's in use.
So are these receivers, are they like low load where they can only take like, accept like one transmission at a time?
Oh yeah, this is one at a time, yeah.
Okay, and so we could be in a queue for all we know.
No, it doesn't work that way. It's
first come, first serve. It's all talking at the same time. Like we could DDoS them by just constantly hitting on this and making noise.
Right.
And there's no like queue to it. It's when it's open, you go. And if you get it, you get it.
Okay, actually it just sounds like Tecmo Bowl. The crowd and then the whistle.
Yeah, somebody blowing a whistle for a foul or something.
Right. Yeah, exactly.
Now it's not responding. So it's possibly because it's getting darker on wherever the station is that they're just not able to receive us as well. So I can change it to closer in, which closer in sometimes may not be good, depending on how your antenna is laid out.
Got it.
Oddly enough. So this one also doesn't look like it's replying. This is kind of generally what this game is you have to kind of call out until you get someone that responds to you, and then you complete your contact. That's CW. That's Morse code.
Oh,
so somebody's just in the space.
Just happens to
around.
Be there.
Yeah, because like, it's all we're allowed to use it for whatever we want. This isn't.
It's not reserved.
For
there's no telling anyone.
Right. It's generally good form. Since he was calling to give him a little bit of time before you try and then throw your email out on top of
it.
So it's just wide open in the air, right? So he could be on here for minutes, hours, I don't know. So generally that's why you hop around a little bit until you find something that's clear and in the open. When we go back to this channel selection screen, the reliability with the green is kind of the stations I'm looking at.
Got it.
I'm looking for the green and not so much the yellows and definitely not the reds.
Sure. In theory, I have to imagine that there's some version of this that's just scripted and will automatically keep trying.
Yes and no. It doesn't want you to automatically retry it. It wants a command operator in the loop.
Oh, because otherwise it's just going to put a bunch of noise.
Yeah. There are some within the amateur radio community that actually don't like Winlink.
They
don't like people using email because they think it's too encoded. So there are some nefarious type people that will actually go into these frequency spaces
to mess with them.
And jam.
Oh, really?
To keep the software from actually transmitting.
Because they're trying to be radio frequency purists, basically?
Right.
Isn't that the kind of thing?
The sanctity of radio.
Wouldn't that get your license revoked if they knew it was you?
Yeah, okay. Or, you know, yes, across the board. So, okay. Yeah, see, there's somebody else in there.
Now, is that in the right range to be an actual communication?
It is, but it's not email. They're using something called RTTY. Which is radio teletype. And that's just a chat room. They're just like chatting back and forth.
Oh, so who knows how long that's going to be.
Yeah. They could be just doing field day. Because field day is just open, so they're just doing whatever they...
Yeah.
Let's go back up this.
What about this 179 here?
That is a frequency I don't really want to use because it's not in tune with the antenna.
Got it.
And it makes it heat up. That's what burned me earlier.
No kidding.
So RF is literally heat.
Yeah, sure.
Well, if the antenna is not matched to the frequency in length that I'm transmitting on, the power that I'm trying to output will come back down the coax.
Got it. So the burning is from you blasting
the radio
the power
was
out.
Transmitting and I was trying to adjust the volume and it went zip. You see this?
Yeah, what is that?
That's
that swooping siren.
Somebody trying to
muck stuff up?
Yeah.
Really?
Because you could hear it's just a siren.
Or it's actual data. It's just a mode I'm not familiar with, potentially. So let's hop off of that for a second. Oh, got it.
Wait.
Maybe.
We got that's a response.
Yeah.
Okay, how far away are we connected to?
369 kilometers.
369 kilometers.
Okay.
It's not done yet. So we are picking up. Now, see how it's center line right on there?
Yeah.
So that's us. We're pulling in.
They're talking to us saying we are ready to receive your message.
Hopefully.
And then that's us responding.
Correct. So that's the receive frame. This is the splatter of data that we're getting.
Yeah. Is this still all the handshaking period?
Yes.
Okay. And then when will we know that the data is being transmitted?
Well, it'll take a couple of minutes.
Hopefully soon.
Oh, it disconnected.
So that we had connection, but it's not going out.
And now somebody else is sending.
It looks like something else is, because it's not in the band space that we were in.
Oh. And that looks like a response.
Oh, okay. How's your Spanish?
Welcome to the chat for adults.
Hey,
we're working it right now.
Wait,
this
it's working.
Is yes.
All right, so we've connected to a Spanish-speaking adult chat room.
It's not a chat room though. He's just being funny.
Okay, all right.
But so we're right now should be sending stuff.
Do we need to send them a picture of Brian with his shirt off?
Maybe that might help. We're transmitting right now. That's why those pauses are longer.
Right.
Because we're actually sending out data.
So the handshake was successful.
The handshake was successful once you get the hello and welcome to the adult massage chat room. In sending state right now. So we are sending.
Sounds like somebody was trying to interrupt.
Yeah, what was that? It sounded like a siren. Down here it says we are sending, and those are the characters we're sending, which get then decompiled or encoded to the email that gets sent.
So I assume we say something and it says it back to make sure that it heard it right, or like a checksum or a parity bit. Yeah,
there's a checksum. So this is both forward error correcting, and then it also has a checksum to make sure that what they received was correct.
Disconnected.
164 bytes we transmitted. 4-minute session.
Was that literally just a person whistling on the radio?
I thought one of us did that. Well, we know we can hit him, so he has another station on 20 meters.
Yep, that's fast response.
We know we got
they're definitely chatting.
Oh, we gotta adjust this a little bit.
The transmission level?
Yeah, the audio outbound of the computer into the sound input from the radio,
that's
which
like
gets
a,
transmitted.
That's like a mixing
board. It's an ALC. Basically. Yeah, exactly.
These are not the hell your whales.
Well, now we have another problem.
What's that?
The battery power on the radio has died.
Oh, son. At the very least, let's start charging this battery.
Somebody's whistling.
Somebody tried to mess it up. This is the clearest back and forth that we've seen
yet. And we are transmitting.
Oh, there's that whistling dude.
I know.
That whistling troll. That's definitely a dude trying to f with us, right?
Dude whistling, yeah.
It's sending. It's sending.
We did this before, though.
You whistling mother. We're gonna send this missive. I'm sorry, we're using your data waves to transmit data. Well, you think you're helping? Why don't you post comments on YouTube where you can truly be useless?
It's trying to send.
So close.
Yeah, I don't hear that whistling dude though. I believe in technology.
Oh no!
What was that?
That's the battery. That's the battery running out.
It's the transmit. It's drawing too much power.
Wait. I just got an email. These are the missile codes.
Yes.
Holy.
Yes.
Holy. These are the missile codes. Hyacinth. Boxcar, Homecoming, Contra 2, Dragon, the chair is against the wall.
And the Janiman.
Oh my God! Oh. As the transmitter died.
Riveting.
That was amazing.
We're all sitting here sweating.
Oh my God, that was incredible.
Wow.
We had power running out. We had thunderstorms making it difficult.
Yes.
We had an active troll trying to
whistle.
Shut down.
Yeah, the Captain Crunch whistle trying to kill the output.
That was amazing.
It's normally much easier than that.
Oh, I believe you, sure.
That was hard. That was the hardest time.
I mean, today is International Troll Day of Shortwave.
Yeah. Everyone is out trying to use the waves.
But that server, you said, was 369 kilometers
away. The station, yeah. And actually, I use this guy when I'm at home in Southern California.
Dude, that is awesome.
Outstanding.
All right, where can everybody learn all of your knowledge about this stuff?
Okay, so the Ham Radio Crash Course, I've done multiple videos on using Winlink before, and I do a live stream where we do live question and answers and stuff like that on all this stuff. Sometimes it's rough.
No, that was an adventure. That was amazing. Are you kidding me?
Tell me, where can we find the Whistler? Let's track him down.
Well, that's a separate video. We would need an antenna. So right now we're using like an omnidirectional antenna. We would need something that we can focus
and then pan around.
It wasn't too loud though, right? So he was somewhere between us, maybe had a big station.
Yeah.
But you can track people down. You just have to pinpoint that RF.
Okay. Oh, man. I'm gonna go get another soda. You work on that.
Yeah. Brian, grab that hammer.
It's gonna be an all-nighter.
Yeah.
How you liking them?
Dude, they just get better and better the more I use them. Can I tell you a secret?
I want to hear it.
I've never had the battery run out on them. Yeah, somebody's grabbing your attention, or you got to place an order at Wendy's or whatever. They go in the pocket. Next thing you know, they're charged again. And by the way, I know we can't legally claim this. They say that they recharge 5 times per day.
Mm-hmm.
They recharge like 7 or 8 times for me. I've never had them run out of battery.
Not once.
We should probably mention what we're talking about.
Yes, Raycon earbuds are new earbuds on the market, and they are at least half the price of other premium earbuds.
And they are good, man. And they've got those customizable rubbery parts.
Yeah.
So they fit your ears.
Mm-hmm. Apparently, I have gigantic, strange inner ear, so I had to get the special weird ones so they wouldn't keep falling out. But Raycon was there for me.
You double tap on podcast, it'll jump it forward 30 seconds, which is primo for ads. Also, never skip the ads.
Don't do that. Don't you ever.
But you double tap and it just jumps it forward. Yep. The hard one for me is 3 in a row. Boop, boop, boop. Like, it turns out, this is how not musical I am. I had to practice a bit to get that down. Like, volume up, volume down. I actually say it in my mind.
You had to play a rhythm game.
It works.
It's all of the controls are really easy to use, and they lull all the super mutants into a nice, docile state.
You're talking about Globally Gloop? I should really figure out his name.
It's hard to pronounce, but don't be racist and weird about it. Come on.
I'm doing Sam Harris's meditation app. It's me, Globally Gloop. I love my Raycons.
Boop, 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 boop.
I got them at buyraycon.com/rogue, and I spelled it right.
15% off. Be cool. Be like a super mutant. Go to buyraycon.com/rogue. Get 15% off your first purchase.
Do these have Harmontown in them?
He's really into podcasts.
Globity Gloobang.
I just immediately pictured a Fallout super mutant trying to put earbuds in.
You're like, do these have Radio Lab?
Radio Lab.
I like it better when Jad is on than Robert.